everyone. Respected Principal Ma'am, Coordinator Ma'am, teachers, parents, and my dear students, I extend my warm and heartiest gratitude to all of you. I welcome you all to the virtual thematic presentation of Class 7G. The topic of this presentation is Our Earth. I hope you all will enjoy this presentation. Before we start, I request all of you to stand for the Devi Gaan.
अविरल निर्मल सलिल सदय ज्ञान प्रदायिनी ज्योतिर्मय हो चहु दिशि उद्घोष अभय दिए विजय जय दिए विजय जय प्रबल प्रवाह मई नित नूतन जीवन दायिनी सदा सनातन वेद प्रणीता परम पुनीता ये धारा अक्षय दिए विजय जय दिए विजय जय दयानंद से प्रेम भक्ति ले हंस राज से त्याग शक्ति ले धर्म भक्ति का राष्ट्र शक्ति का हो दिन मान उदय दिए विजय जय दिए विजय जय सुख समृद्धि इसकी लहरें प्रेम शांति इसके तट ठहरे सघन शांतिमय प्रबल क्रांतिमय लिए अटल निश्चय दिए विजय जय दिए विजय जय
Mother Earth, our home planet, is the third planet from the sun and the only place we know of so far that's inhabited by living things. While Earth is the only fifth largest planet in the solar system, it is the only world in our solar system with liquid water on the surface. Just slightly larger than nearby Venus, Earth is the biggest of four planets closest to the sun, all of which are made of rock and metal.
The name Earth is at least 1,000 years old. All the planets except for Earth were named after Greek and Roman gods and goddesses. However, the name Earth is a Germanic word which simply means the ground. Scientists have found thousands of other worlds, but they are not like Earth. Some of my friends are going to tell why Mother Earth is so unique.
तुझे नमन है धरती माता तेरी वायु बिना न संभव इस जग में जीवित रह पाना तू ही जल से प्यास बुझाती देती तू ही सबको दाना धरा न होती पाव तले तो मानव तनिक नहीं चल पाता तुझे नमन है धरती माता तुझे नमन है धरती माता
धरती के गोद में होती माता के आंचल सी ममता इस पर फैले नील गगन में पिता सदृश संरक्षण क्षमता पंच तत्व के योगदान से तू ही सबकी प्राण प्रदाता तुझे नमन है धरती माता तुझे नमन है धरती माता
युगो युगो से अपनी धरती जल चेतन को धारण करती आवश्यकता सब पूरी कर ये जीवन को खुशियों से भरती सहन शक्ति का लेके निष्की मानव अनुचित लाभ उठाता तुझे नमन है धरती माता तुझे नमन है धरती माता
रूप धरा का लश भरश कर करे नहीं हम इसको खंडे क्रुद हुई अगर ये तो वत वंशों से होगे डंडे रक्षित हो जीवन मानव से जो जीवों में श्रेष्ठ कहता तुझे नमन है धरती माता तुझे नमन है धरती माता
सामने हो मंजिल तो रास्ते ना मोड़ना जो भी मन में हो वो सपना ना तोड़ना कदम कदम पर मिलेगी मुश्किल है आपको सितारे चुनने के लिए जमीन न छोड़ना तुझे नमन है धरती माता तुझे नमन है धरती माता
Many species rely on fresh water besides humans as a vital component to their survival. Overuse of fresh water in household settings means there is less fresh water for agricultural use, which of course affects humans on a food scarcity level. But many livestock species rely on fresh water. Also, as we divert more fresh water from aquatic environments to supplement agriculture, many plant and animal species are threatened or can become endangered.
Wasting water while our demand for water increases as population and standards of living increase globally means that we need to supplement for this lack of fresh water by pulling it out of aquifers or groundwater supplies in which their regeneration rate is lower than the extraction rate. This unsustainable practice decreases long-term water security and availability. A few of my buddies are going to tell you why wasting water is a much bigger problem than we think.
Discussing about one of the most important and precious resources required for our survival on earth, that is water. We tend to think of water as a very common and easily available substance. However, we all know that only 0.3% of the earth's fresh water is readily available for use.
We use water for activities like drinking, cooking, bathing, washing clothes, cleaning, washing utensils and vehicles, farming and industrial purposes. Water is also essential for maintaining good health as it helps in regulating body temperature, aids in digestion and removes toxins from our body.
We all know and realize the importance of water in our daily life, but often are not very careful about using it judiciously.
Considered precious, but the amount of readily available and usable water on the earth is decreasing alarmingly. So, here are some consequences of water shortage.
In our day-to-day life, water can be saved on the global scale. And now, you must have understood that water scarcity can not only affect us humans, but also the agriculture on a large scale.
Correctly said, Manan. So, considering the water scarcity issues in the present time, the main question that arises is that how to end water scarcity?
So, let me tell you a few ways to overcome this problem of water scarcity. First of all, we must create awareness among the people about innovative technologies that can help conserving water. Secondly, use of sprinklers and drip irrigation techniques should also be implemented. And importantly, while watering the plants, we must use a mug instead of a pipe. And lastly, get the leaking taps repaired immediately.
We must encourage water conservation because there's no life without water.
Save water through water conservation, as water is life and conservation is future.
Waste water today and face a dry tomorrow. Spare water today to thrive tomorrow.
Think and think before wasting water in the sink.
present we, the present generation, can give to a future generation.
Yeah, so true. It is the Earth's relationship to the sun and the amount of light it receives that is responsible for the seasons and biodiversity. The Earth receives almost all its energy from the sun radiation.
Surya Namaskar, also known as sun salutation or salute to the sun, is a practice in yoga as an exercise will incorporating a sequence of 12 gracefully linked asanas. My friend Adya will show you the same.
Om Mitraay Namaha. Om Ravaye Namaha. Om Suryaay Namaha. Om Bhanave Namaha. Om Khagaya Namaha. Om Pushnaye Namaha. Om Hiranyagarbhaya Namaha. Om Marichaye Namaha. Om Adityaya Namaha. Om Savitre Namaha. Om Arkaya Namaha. Om Bhaskaraya Namaha. Om Mitraya Namaha. Om Ravaye Namaha. Om Suryaya Namaha. Om Bhanave Namaha. Om Khagaya Namaha. Om Pushnaye Namaha. Om
Ayush, do you know some Earth scientists use their knowledge of the planet to locate and develop energy and mineral resources?
Oh yes, I read in a magazine that typically Earth scientists use tools from geology, chronology, physics, chemistry, geography, biology, and mathematics to build quantitative understanding of how Earth works and evolves.
My friends will apprise us with some interesting mathematical concepts and facts.
Planet Earth, that shiny blue marble that has fascinated humanity since they first began to walk across its surface. And why shouldn't it fascinate us? In addition to being our home and the place where life, as we know, it originated, it remains the only planet where life thrives. And in the course of past few centuries, we have learned much about Earth that has only deepened our fascination about it.
Our first fact is the total area of the world's land is 148.94 million kilometers square, and the total area of the world that is covered in water is 361.132 million kilometers square.
Our second fact is about Earth's population. Total population of Earth is equal to 7.9 billion people. Each year, there are 18.6 births and 7.8 deaths per 1,000 people. So, the growth rate is equal to 18.6 minus 7.8, which is equal to 10.8 per 1,000 people, which is approximately 1.1%. The Earth's population was 1 billion in 1804 and 7 billion in 2011. So, the ratio of Earth's population in 1804 to Earth's population in 2011 is equal to 1:7.
The third fact is, the sun is 92.95 million miles away from the Earth. The moon's radius is 1,079 miles and of Earth at the equator is 3,963 miles.
Fourth fact is, Earth has a mass of 660 tons, but no weight at all, it is free floating in space.
When we talk about maths, we all think about numbers, books, computers, etc. But do you know that mass presence is also in nature, though it doesn't sound relevant at all? The following examples will show you how mass is shown through wonderful things in our natural world.
This is one of the most popular examples which shows symmetry in nature. In particular, they indicate six-fold radical symmetry whose arms have identical elaborate patterns.
So, our second example is sunflowers. These beautiful flowers show radial symmetry as well as a kind of numerical symmetry called the Fibonacci sequence. In this sequence, we determine each number by adding together the two numbers preceding it.
Numbers like 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, 55, 89, 144, 233, 377 and so on. These series of numbers is known as Fibonacci sequence. Here we obtain a number by adding the previous two numbers like 1 plus 1 equal to 2, 1 plus 2 equal to 3, 2 plus 3 equal to 5, 3 plus 5 equal to 8, 5 plus 8 equal to 13, 8 plus 13 equal to 21. So, by adding two numbers, we get the next number of the Fibonacci sequence. If we see the center of the sunflower and from the center, if we see the beads, that forms a spiral and many spirals are formed. So, this is the center, the way it goes out from inside to outside. This is an example of Fibonacci sequence.
The third example is pine cones. The seed pods of pine cones arrange in a spiral pattern. They have two spirals, each of which twist upwards in opposing directions. Most of the time, the step number will match a pair of consecutive Fibonacci numbers.
Last but not the least, the fourth example is honeycombs. Mankind has long been amazed by honeycomb's hexagonal figures. Bees instinctively can be, but humans would need a compass and a ruler if they want to reproduce this structure. Honeycombs indicate wallpaper symmetry in which a pattern is repeated until it fully covers a plane. It is believed by the mathematicians that the bees chose the structure as this is the most efficient to store most honey possible with the smallest amount of wax.
Thank you, friends. Zaira, did you notice that sea levels are rising and oceans are becoming warmer, longer, more intense droughts threaten crops, wildlife, and fresh water supplies, from polar bears in the Arctic to marine turtles off the coast of Africa? Our planet's diversity of life is at risk from the changing climate.
Yes, this is the impact of global warming on the Earth.
I have heard this term, but can you tell me what does it mean?
Yeah, sure. Global warming means a gradual increase in the overall temperature of Earth's atmosphere, generally attributed to the greenhouse effect caused by increased levels of carbon dioxide, CFCs, and other pollutants. To understand better, some of our friends are here to help.
Hello, Nanya. How are you doing?
Hello, Tasya. I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm also good. Have you read the newspaper today?
No, I didn't. What is the matter? You sound tensed.
The headlines say, many parts of various continents and islands have become warm due to the global warming.
Oh no, but could you please tell me what is global warming?
Global warming means Earth absorbs about 75% of the total solar energy reaching its surface, thereby increasing its temperature. Some of this energy is radiated back into the atmosphere. The gases present in the atmosphere, for example, ozone, methane, carbon dioxide, water vapor, chlorofluorocarbons, are called greenhouse gases. They absorb some heat, thereby restricting the heat to escape our atmosphere. These gases add to the heating of the atmosphere and result in global warming.
In a greenhouse, the solar energy enters through the glass, warms the soil and atmosphere, and helps in the growth of plants. In return, the soil and plants emit infrared radiation, which is partly absorbed and partly reflected by the glass. This mechanism traps the sun's energy in greenhouse. Similarly, we have carbon dioxide, which absorbs heat as they are transparent sunlight but not to infrared heat radiation, and is the major contributor of the global warming.
Process of global warming is when you enter a car that has been in the sun for quite some time, what's the first thing you notice? It's a lot hotter inside than it is outside. The sun's rays, UV radiation, thermal radiation and visible light enter the car through the glass panes, and all the rays entering the car do not leave owing to the buildup of gases inside the car and refractive properties of the glass itself, the weaker thermal radiation do not completely leave the car. This eventually heats up the inside of the car.
Greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide and increase of all these gases is all our fault. Things like air conditioner and refrigerator contain CFC, chlorofluorocarbon, which is harmful to environment. Some greenhouse gases like methane are produced and from burning of fossil fuels like coal, oil and gas. Another primary source of CO2 is deforestation. The process releases up to 4.8 million metric tons of carbon into the atmosphere every year.
Climate change due to global warming. A universal consensus of climate scientists is that there has definitely been a rise in the global temperature over the past century. The phenomenon of global warming, if continued unchecked, will have profound implications. One of the main effects of global warming will be the rise in sea and ocean levels. Currently, this is already occurring around us. Melting of glacier and polar ice caps will contribute to the rising water levels all over the world. Apart from these, fresh water sources will also reduce. According to scientific bodies like NASA, other consequences of global warming are ocean acidification, extreme weather events, and other natural and social impacts.
So can we control or check this from happening? There are some like Joseph Verney, an associate professor at the Department of Geology and Planetary Science at the University of Pittsburgh, who believes that we all have crossed the point of no return. All we can do now is to adapt the changing environment and risking ocean and sea levels. We can still lessen the severity of climate change by aggressively enforcing policies that require different bodies to lessen CO2 in the atmosphere. Still, others are even more optimistic, believing that strong international agreements and actions can save the planet and its changing environment. We should follow three rules: reduce, reuse, recycle. Carry your own shopping bags, do not use plastic bags. Turn off the lights when not in use. Power your homes with renewable energy. We should stop deforestation and promote afforestation. I hope you will follow these steps and make Earth a better place to live in.
Oh, Prithvi Mata, the vast one, is the Sanskrit name for the Earth, as well as the name of a Devi in Hinduism and some branches of Buddhism, with its oldest text dating back to around 1500 BCE. Sanskrit is probably the second oldest language in the world still being used today.
Yes, and today some of our friends are going to demonstrate the beauty of Earth in Sanskrit language.
Atharved mein kaha gaya hai, mata bhumi putro aham prithivyah, arthat bhumi meri mata hai aur main uska putra hoon. Yajurved mein bhi kaha gaya hai, namo matre prithivyah, arthat matra bhumi ko namaskar hai. चलिए उसी पृथ्वी
माँ को आज हम नमन करते
हैं। भूमि मैं तुम्हें नमन करता हूँ। जल से तुष्ट करती है, घर में बसाती है, अन्न से पुष्ट करती है हमारी यह भूमि।
धनिक च न निर्धन पोषति, न धर्म न च जाति, संभावन पश्यति सविद भूमिर्यम अस्माकर धन्यवाद।
धनी और निर्धन में भेद नहीं करती, न धर्म देखती है न जात, सभी में संभाव पूर्ण करती है हमारी भूमि। धन्यवाद।
संरक्षण एतस्य स्वच्छताये अस्य येन भवेत् शक्तिपूर्ण अस्माभिः किंचित् करणीयम्।
इसके संघर्ष के लिए, इसकी स्वच्छता के लिए, जिससे यह शक्तिपूर्ण हो, हमें भी कुछ करना चाहिए। धन्यवाद।
It is truly said that the proper use of science is not to conquer nature, but to live in it. Two of my friends are here for a beautiful poem, The Earth Speaks by Lenore Headrick.
Determining Earth spoke in a somber voice,
four seasons I give you, it's deep voice said. I give you spring when the lilacs bloom. I give you autumn when the maple is red. Summer I give you all grown with sunshine and winter with snow and icicles fierce. Four seasons I give you with all the pleasures, all the joys and all the fears.
Take my four gifts and use each one. Use each wisely, kindly and well, so that upon the year's last hour, a worthy record you did to tell. The turning earth spoke but once again. Four seasons I give you, its voice was low. The gifts are yours and yours is the task to use my gifts as best as you know.
How is it possible that the most intellectual creature to ever walk the planet Earth is destroying its only home? We are living on this planet as if we had another one to go. The greatest threat to the planet Earth is the belief that someone else would save it. Rightly quoted by the great Dalai Lama, it is our collective and individual responsibility to preserve and tend to this world in which we all live. Let us all pledge to make this world a better place to live in.
Dance is silent poetry and the hidden language of the soul.
Let's end this program with a graceful dance performance.
Request Ma'am Principal to share her experience and encourage us with her words of wisdom.
I really don't have words to express that, you know, these presentations, the thematic presentations that we have these days for all classes, they are coming out so beautifully. The message that you have given today, children, I don't want that it should remain restricted only to our presentations today. In fact, it should go further and you all become our brand ambassadors who are sharing this noble message amongst your neighbors, in your family, in your friends, and overall bring a change in our social environment. More than that, children, you have performed beautifully. The way you have enacted today, this brings out your inner talent. And this is one of the main purposes of our thematic presentations, my dear parents. It is to identify the talent of our children, to give them opportunity to express themselves. And I feel that some children, you know, they don't get chance in assemblies or in inter-house competitions, but through thematic presentations, we want to give this chance to each and every student. And I'm very sure every year when they participate in such presentations, their personality is going to be groomed in a wonderful manner. I thank you, my dear parents, for your support in helping us groom our children and develop their overall personality. Because it is not only academics that is important, but along with that, what is also important is how they express themselves. They should be confident. And we both, parents and teachers, have to instill this confidence in our children. So thank you, my dear children. And special congrats, I would say well done to dear children who have performed so well. Your teachers gave you the ideas, your parents guided you, but you are the ones who have put life into all this. So congratulations once again, and well done, my dear teachers also. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your words of motivation. They mean a lot to us. These students have put in the efforts because you had the trust and the faith that yes, they'll be able to do it. It was your vision that helped us to, you know, find out the hidden talents in the students and bring them forward. So thank you so much for this opportunity. I extend heartiest thanks to my dear parents, because without your support, this would not have been possible. You've really worked hard with your children in helping them make the videos and arranging the dresses and everything for them. So thank you so much. Thank you all the teachers and my dear children. Thank you, ma'am, once again.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your constant support and guidance, without which we couldn't have even imagined the successful conduction of this session. In the end, on behalf of the students of Class 7G, I would like to take the opportunity to express my sincere and deepest gratitude to all the mentor teachers for their unflinching support and guidance, without which this session would not have been possible. I would also like to thank all the parents for motivating us with their presence today.